Hi guys, Devjit here from webasicyoutube.com. In this video I am going to tell you how to design Bootstrap for Navbar. Okay, so as you can see, I am taking a document and save it at header.html, and this is that standard structure of the any HTML5 document. So now I have to go and download Bootstrap CSS and JS file from getbootstrap.com. For that I open that getbootstrap.com. This is the file, getbootstrap.com, you can see. And after that, clicking the download, one zip file will be downloaded. I already downloaded, so I am not going to download it again. I just showing you the what will be the content in this zip file. Okay, so it will be the zip file, and if you open that, you will find CSS and JS folder. In the CSS, take that Bootstrap, this one, and you can take that minified version also. Means Bootstrap min.css. This two is either of any one you can take it. And similarly in the JS also we need Bootstrap.js, and you can take that as well as minified version. And we need the standard jQuery file, and you can use CND also. If you want CND, then the Bootstrap also already provide that CND link of that CSS file and jQuery file also. You can directly copy paste from here, but I like manually, so let's add them. Link rel is equal to style set, href is equal to CSS Bootstrap.css. Okay, and question is usually awesome. Let's close it. Similarly, name tab that JavaScript file. Script source. First of all, we have to the jQuery file, you have to load first. After that you need to add Bootstrap.js. Script is an C in JS, now to print Bootstrap.js. Okay, let's save it. Okay, so now I have to take that, and I have to start to write to designing the navigation. For that, I have to check the nav tag name. I think this is not get linked up properly. Let's do it again. Okay, sorry, let's link it properly only. Nav class. The class will be very important. Navbar. And you can take Navbar default if you want the gray background, and if you want little black background, then take Navbar inverse. I am taking here Navbar inverse. No, I am going to change that. And If you want full height navbar, then make it in container fluid, and if you want box layout content, then I'm taking here box layout. I'm using container. Container. In the container, you have to take bottom. Bottom type will be same bottom, and class will be navbar toggle. And data toggle will be collapsed. And data target. Equal to, you can take any ID name. Here I am going to take my number as my number. Close the button, save it. So see, this black icon is black bar is coming, and so right, and I'm going to taking that now toggle bottom hot will be the inside, means three bar will be there now, like this portion, total three bar will be there. Like for that, I'm right span class. In the class, I have to specify icon. Icon bar span three time. I have to take that because I want three lines actually. See, like. The two line, but it will be in standard, it will be in three line. So move one time, see, and then it will come up total three. And after that, I have to write that brand name actually. On the brand name, I have to go down on the bottom and start to write the anchor tag, anchor A. And now class will be navbar brand. Navbar brand, and after navbar brand is reference. I'm keep it empty, and after that will be sorry, and you can take any image or you can take any I'm taking a text also. I'm keeping this text only brand. Okay, one thing I forgot, I mean you have to after container you have to mention navbar header actually. Take a div, it's very easy actually. Class and navbar header, and take that name, the end session, cut it and paste it after anchor tag. Okay, alignment. After this dim, I have to make that all the list item. So take another dim. Class. This class will be collapsed. Collapse and number collapse. After number collapse, just have to now mention that the same ID name whatever I specify before. I mean, like whatever the name is there, I have to specify the same ID name. Okay, so take that ID, and ID will be just copy the name from here, paste it. My number, just now close it. In this dim, you have to specify UL. Class nav number name, yeah, and I want to write all the LI item, so doing the right side, so number right. Close it. Now specify the LI. I want 4 LI actually. So LI into 4. Have it, all LI will come. And all will be, HDF will be there. And all the anchor tag. So A. Is equal to has bracket and all. Okay, we take all the tag empty only here. Okay, now close. And for that first one, I'm taking the class and class active. And here I am writing home about us our work and sorry, this will be this position in between anchor tag. And contact us. Okay. Now it's almost completed. Just save it. And check the live preview. It's working properly. In the full height, it will come all this in that side. Okay, you can see little border radius here. Actually, you can easily remove that by using some CSS property. For that, I use on page only, but try to recommend use external CSS style. And dot number and border radius is equal to 0. Margin bottom also is a default, some 10 pixel margin by default given by Bootstrap. You can remove that also. Margin bottom is equal to gigabits. Let's save it and check. See, this border radius is gone. So here, how to design Bootstrap Navbar. For designing Bootstrap 4 and the portion, stay tuned and subscribe my channel. I'll teach you every component how to design them.